Hello everyone, what is going on? In today's video, I have for you guys a nice cool unboxing of this iPhone 11 Pro Max in gold with the 256 gigabyte storage variant. Over the last 4 years, I have consistently gotten the new iPhone. I originally had the Samsung Galaxy Note 4 somewhere around early high school, and then I got the iPhone 7 Plus when the Samsung Galaxy Note 7 started. And so because of that, I switched from the Android / Samsung life to the Apple iPhone life. And after the 7 Plus, I got the 10. After the 10, I got the 10S Max. And now here I am with the iPhone 11 Pro Max. I'm not a big fan of the naming scheme, but it makes sense. It's not weird like the 10R and the 10S, how in terms of the alphabet, it's an XS Max, but it's X10, SS, 10S Max, 10R, even though it's XR. See, it makes a lot of sense now. It's 11 Pro Max. So yeah, let's go ahead and just get right into this unboxing. I actually don't think I need these scissors. Ooh, that's satisfying. I believe the iPhone 4 and the iPhone 8 came with the black boxes, but the 7 Plus, 10 and 10S Max did not. So this is a nice touch to now have the black box back. I think that's pretty awesome. And I'm just gonna go ahead and compare this to what I have in my pocket, the 10S Max. But yeah, I don't know why I got off topic like that. Let's just go ahead and continue with this unboxing. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pop open the box. Here is the phone. I'm gonna go ahead and just leave it there for right now. And then when you do that, you have this little white packet designed by Apple in California. Just your typical hello tags. Comes with a SIM card tray thingy installer, so that way I can switch SIM cards. Some more stuff, and then your Apple stickers. Nothing new, nothing weird, until we get to something here in a couple seconds, which is this new charger. This is the new 18 watt fast charger. This is also USB Type-C to Lightning. So let me show you what it used to be. So the 10S Max came with this square 5-watt charger that is USB-A to Lightning, but I use my iPad Pro charger, which is a 12-watt fast charger. So 5-watt, 12-watt, 18-watt. So I'll be able to charge my iPad Pro and my iPhone 11 Pro Max a lot faster. And the fact that it's USB Type-C is really handy for something I'm gonna show you guys later on in this video. But let's go put these away. We do have the normal ear pods, not AirPods. And then, like I said, the USB Type-C to Lightning charger. And that's it, nothing else. And here we are, the iPhone 11 Pro Max in gold. Let's go ahead and peel off the sticker. Ooh, this is the iPhone 11 Pro Max. Let me go ahead and take this case off of my phone. So here we are comparing both golds. This is the iPhone XS Max in 256 gigabyte gold. Once again, iPhone 11 Pro Max, 256 gigabyte gold. You should be able to tell the difference by the camera bump and the fact that the 11 Pro Max now has a matte finish. So looking at these two, they're very, very identical. In my opinion, maybe I'm wrong, I don't know how to judge it, but the 11 Pro Max looks a little more yellowy, a little more pronounced, while the XS Max looks a little on the paler side. In terms of their side profile, it looks to be the exact same shade of gold. I don't really notice a difference. In terms of the power button placement, whatever, the 11 Pro Max is just ever so slightly lower. And in terms of the volume rocker stuff, the same thing. The volume buttons and the ringer is just ever so slightly lower. They're so subtly different that it just doesn't make a difference. In terms of the bottom, you have the same speaker grill on the right and microphone grill on the left. And the weight, people say it's a lot heavier, but it doesn't feel heavier. I think people are just trying to find a way to make it different than the XS Max. But let's be real, Apple doesn't market their products to last generation owners. They don't market this 11 Pro Max to 10S Max users. They're marketing to people with older iPhones, like the 6, the 6S, the 5, the 4, the SE. They're marketing to those people. And they're also marketing to Android users and other cell phone branded users. So I find it really annoying when people like to rant about Apple saying they're not being innovative. Like, of course not. Like, at least they're coming out with a new phone every year, not coming out with something. For a user that is gonna buy a new iPhone, I would take the free features that come with the 11 Pro Max that weren't on the XS Max for the same price. At the time of their release, these are both $1,250 smartphones. So I don't see why people complain about how they're not really being innovative when, if a user were to buy this anyway, why not just get the same phone with better features for the same price? Little side rant. I just want to say that I hate when people try to compare it to the last generation. I know that these are the most subtly different phones, but that's because they're not going to dramatically change things. It's not like an iOS 7 type thing where iOS 6 and iOS 7 were dramatically different. So I don't blame Apple for that. These phones are so similar that they're basically the same thing. I need to take a break. I got really, really fired up there. Let's talk about the back. The XS Max has a completely gold, glossy, clear, I don't know what you call the finish, but it's a clear back. And the iPhone Apple logo is somewhere in like the second quadrant, like between 25 and 50%, while the Apple logo in the 11 Pro Max is now straight dead in the center. There's also no iPhone text. All you see is literally the Apple logo and the cameras. And personally, I think I like it. It's a lot more simple, it's a lot more clean, a lot more elegant. And then now the finish on the 11 Pro Max is a matte finish, while the camera bump is a glossy finish. So that gloss is the same gloss that is on the XS Max. They both have that nice sheen. So with the XS Max, it comes with a normal slash wide lens and a telephoto lens that gives you 2x zoom. But now on the 11 Pro Max, it comes with 3 cameras. So you get from 0.5 zoom to a 4x zoom. So now you have that wider range. You have the ultra wide camera, you have the normal slash wide, and you have the telephoto. But the bumps, it's kind of annoying because the XS Max only has one bump and people were already complaining about the one bump. But here with the 11 Pro Max, there is a slight bump with the square and there's an even slighter, bigger bump with the cameras. So if I were to run my fingers up here, bump and another bump. There's two bumps. Basically, the notches are the exact same. The resolution is the exact same, but now the 11 Pro Max has a more contrasty OLED screen. So I believe it's a 2,000,000:1, while this is probably 1,900,000:1, I don't know. And I believe this has up to 600 nits of brightness. This has up to 800 with up to 1200 for HDR videos. So slightly brighter, slightly more contrasty, but otherwise same resolution, same notch. So if you guys are interested, I will do a full review. I'll probably actually already do a 1 month review. I'll go ahead and get my initial thoughts on this. And yeah, just to tell you what's to come in my next video. So I'll probably link it up above somewhere in one of these two directions. I'll be unboxing the 11 Pro Max leather case. And I also ordered the Apple Watch Series 5. So that will be coming in. They did not have it in stock, so I had to order it. So it'll be coming in just a little bit. But other than that, I'm gonna go ahead and cut to the tiny cool clip about the USB Type-C charger, but I'm out of here. This is pretty much the unboxing. So simple, so clean, so nice. And you know, it's just the newest iPhone every year. So if you guys like this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. Okay, so this is the tiny, nice, subtle detail that I like about the new iPhone 11 Pro Max. So over here, I have the two iPhones. On the left is my XS Max, and on the right is my 11 Pro Max with their respective chargers. So this is USB Type A, and this is USB Type C. I cannot charge my iPhone XS Max with my MacBook Pro because MacBook Pro only has Thunderbolt 3 / USB Type-C ports, but now with the new iPhone 11 Pro Max, I can now charge my 11 Pro Max with my MacBook Pro. That is something I wished was already there since 2016 when the MacBook Pro first came out, because it does not make any sense why you cannot charge your iPhone with your MacBook Pro with the charger it already comes with. So thank you, Apple. This is the most awesome, subtle detail ever.